Yeah, today I'm bringing you guys a good news. Guess where I am? I'm at the David Tomaso lawsuit office right now. For those of you who are refugees in Israel and you want to migrate to Canada, yeah, the road is open now. David is on it now. You won't go to Canada from Israel. It no matter whether you get visa or you don't get visa. Come meet David. He could tell you what to do. Make una know they call me. Don't call me. You got to call David. I will tell you guys, when you come to NYC, opposite NYC Hotel, what's the name of this street?
Menachem Begin. Near to the Tachana.
This house is 44, right?
Yeah, 44.
Number 44. You come here and ask David questions. Now, before I proceed to ask David, I have three things that I'm going to discuss here. First of all, people with their visa don't expire. What is their fate right now in Israel? So David will answer these little questions before I go out of this place. So right now, listen. Mr. David,
yes.
We are here once again. I see you are too busy. Pam, 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 the internet, everything, you're busy typing.
We must. We have some things in the computers. We have people in the jail. We need to help people.
Wow. You also help people that are jailed.
Yes, we're doing everything about helping people.
Helping people. I have three questions. But first, I want to talk about the Canada issue.
Oh.
And you know, I didn't come here because of the Canada issue. Because as I was just sitting around here, I saw this paper here. Canada, what? I saw the paper. I said, maybe you have started to process the Canada visa to people. So, have you started processing the Canada visa?
Truly,
at the moment.
Truly, you come here for another thing.
Yes. Because I saw the paper around.
You see the papers on the desk.
Yeah.
Yes, we start the things of Canada again.
Yeah.
The things that I was doing 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Truly, the problem was not with us. The problem that we stopped to doing it was because of the United Nations.
Okay.
They was helping two Eritrean and Sudanese go to Canada.
Yeah.
And now they stopped it. And now we start to do it with Nigerians, Ghanaian, South Africans,
Kenyans,
all countries, Indians, Sri Lankans, Ukrainian. Everything.
Yeah.
What happened? That suddenly we start with this matter again.
Yeah.
The corona. Because of the corona, the COVID-19.
Yeah.
There is not people that can work in Canada. Not in the factories, not in agriculture, not in restaurants, not in constructions.
So they need people in Canada?
So they need people.
Wow.
So now they open a new visa. New visa in Canada.
Yeah.
That give us the chance for all the people. You are from Africa, you are from Russia, you are from Asia, you are from India, you are from everywhere in the world. You can go there. And it's not simple, but it's much easier than 3 years ago. Why?
Okay.
Because now people there, the ones that have the control if you are there or not. Example, if there is one restaurant in Toronto.
Okay.
And they need 4 workers. And they don't found any workers in Canada. They have the rights by the law to invite 4 people from each country that they choose. But the most important things, no criminal issues, no background of criminal issues.
Yeah.
If you know English, it's perfect. If you have education papers, it's perfect.
Yeah.
Everything is much easier. But I must to say the truth. I cannot talk about how much it costs.
No, they have to come and discuss with you.
They must to come and discuss with me. Why? Because each person
is very
the same.
Okay.
It's not the same.
Okay, it's not the same, yeah.
It's not the same. So I can tell someone X, and someone to be X plus something.
Yeah.
Or X minus something. Yeah. So I cannot say nothing. But for the first advice They can come here, I'm not charging nothing. If it's okay, we continue the process. I tell you, X, Y, Z, everything. I'm already now on a few cases to Canada.
Okay.
I'm dealing with them on the internet. They're calling me, I send them email, they call me back, I send them email, they see me back. Mm. I can show you from you see?
Yeah.
You see, I get invitation from a Canadian embassy. You see, please know that your email was forwarded to Visa Immigration Section for reply. You see, I get everything. You see, what is the application? They ask me what is the application number, what is your complete name, what is your date of birth. Everything they send me. You see, from Embassy of Canada to Israel.
Yeah, yeah.
They send me every time I'm dealing with them about many, many cases. The most important thing is that you pay minority payments on the beginning. Mm. And all of the money you pay only when you get the visa.
Wow.
You understand?
You pay a little money.
You pay, you know, so it's not little.
Yeah, but like
deposit.
Yeah.
Deposit for the papers.
Yeah.
But I'm telling you the truth.
Yeah.
I'm not starting if you don't have chance. Mm-hmm. Before I collect the money, I send to my office in Canada your CV. They tell me, David, we have the person that want to invite them. It's not like before, G5, committee sponsor, no.
You know, David, you said something the other time. There's one lady that came to meet me around 8 o'clock in the night. She said, please, I want to invite my husband if I go. I said, I don't know, come to David and ask.
Okay.
You were telling me that if somebody spent 1 year in Canada, he can bring his families.
With this visa, after 1 year in Canada, if you are okay, if you don't have criminal issues there, okay?
Yeah.
If you're not involved in criminal issues, like drugs, criminal issues, everything, if you are okay, after 1 year, you have the right to call all your family coming to Canada. If your husband, your wife and your children. Hmm. If your wife, your husband and your children. If your husband, the wife and the children. After 1 year, and you will get permanent resident in Canada.
Hmm.
Magnificent. It's something that was, people say the corona is bad, it's very bad.
Yeah,
but this opportunity come because of the corona. So
this is another opportunity.
Yes, yes.
Wow.
It's something unbelievable.
Guys, when I don't hear now, those of you that are Nigeria, Ghana, Ethiopia, Russia, India, Philippines, whichever country that you come from, you can migrate from here. Come and see David. So I'm going to put his number right on the screen. So David, we have talked about Canada now. Now let's talk about the people that are here, that they have a renewal. They want to renew their visa.
Yes.
What is going on now?
Now, because of the corona, the Minister of Interior are closed. The Minister of Interior are closed. But don't be worried. All of the visas are renewed automatically. But if you have lawyer, it can be David, it can be another one, you call your lawyer 1 day before the date of the renewal, and he will tell you if it's open or closed. The one that already was renewed before, they're supposed to renew like yesterday. Don't be worried. It's renewal automatically. I can show you now some of my clients. They get SMS. New SMS.
Okay.
With invitation on 31st of January. Do you see it there in the computer?
Yeah. 31st/01/2021.
They get automatically renewed until 31st of January 2021. Next year, after 3 months, automatically. You must not be worried. Now, if people don't have papers and the employed want papers that make proof that you are legal in Israel, you can go to your lawyer and ask a paper. They say, Mr. XYZ is legally in Israel. And the lawyer will put a stamp and it must be enough okay. for the employment people.
Okay.
Everything is very easy. Now, if there's people with interview, the lawyer supposed to get a new invitation for the interview day.
You know, those people that they invite for interview.
Yes, okay. They must not be worried. They will get also SMS. The visa is automatically renewed. And when they will go to Bnei Brak, they will get new invitation, or the Minister of Interior, RSD sections, will send it to the lawyer, the new invitation of the new date of the interview date. But most important things, all the people must not be afraid. You are legal in Israel. All the refugees, they have blue paper that was supposed to renew it on this time, on the corona time. You are legal in Israel. Until you will not get the SMS, you are legal in Israel. When you get the SMS, you go to renew the visa and you will see there if they will give you interview, if they will renew a visa or not. Everything is according to his file.
Yeah.
But don't be worried from nothing. If there are any questions, you can call to my office. You can call to your lawyers. You ask them your questions. This is why the people are paying us spend money. This is your time to call us, the lawyers, to give you the service that you paid for this already.
David, please call your number for these people. These people, they normally disturb me.
A lot of people disturb me. Really, they're not supposed to call you at all. They're supposed to call to the lawyer.
Then they see me as a lawyer. I say, I'm not a lawyer.
No.
call your number for them, please.
Private number is 054-774-8786. David, you can call me. If I not pick up the phone, you send me SMS. I will send you SMS back. You can WhatsApp me. I will WhatsApp you back. I have an emo. You can emo me. I can send you an answer by emo. I know every day what's happening in the Ministry of Interior. In Bnei Brak, if it's open or closed. In Tel Aviv, there is interview or not. Everything, what's happening in Bnei Brak, in Tel Aviv, I know, but every day is a new day. So today it's closed. Tomorrow I know it's closed. What will be in Thursday? I think it's also closed. Sunday, it's a new day, new week. If someone have a renewal date on Sunday or Monday or Tuesday next week, call me. I will update you if it's closed or open.
Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. David. You've given them enough information.
Thank you. Also,
I've tried my best to give you people information for free. Don't be... How do I put it? There's an English that says, don't be selfish. Press like on that video and drop a comment. A lot of you meet me on the stage without even dropping a comment. Say, oh, brother, you try. They just read, they just watch. When they see you on the street, now they begin to appreciate me. Don't appreciate me on the street. Appreciate me by putting a comment down below and share my video. Thank you very much. God bless you guys. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Solomon Okereke vlog. Do I look handsome? Is it a Photoshop? I did handsome now. I'm waiting.